Hey guys, welcome back to Killer 7. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Today, we're gonna start up with some sunset action. Left or right? Oh my god, how about right in the middle? Bam! This is gonna be good. Unfortunately, well, depending on how you look at it, we're gonna have a lot of cutscenes to start off here, so if for some reason you're not interested in the story, I guess you could skip ahead, but that'd be really foolish, so I don't recommend it, honestly. Anyways, let's get this shit started, as always. With a full moon, here we go.
July 3rd, 1998, the day that all international disputes were resolved. This day marked the beginning of true peace for the entire world, for people of all races. The four powers quickly formed anti-terrorist organizations and set out creating peacekeeping agencies to bring order and security on a global scale. The world unified to do everything in its power to eradicate all the weeds of evil and disorder. The International Society, under the motto of protecting the world from international terrorism, ideology terrorism, and cyber terrorism, stopped all air transportation and closed every network station in a short span of 2 years to reduce the likelihood of terrorism. The world had changed. In the year 2002, a network of intercontinental expressways bridging the Atlantic Ocean opened, connecting the two major sides of the world. In the following year of 2003, the construction of a mass-scale distribution system began, and a man-made landmass as large as a city was built over an ocean. The use and research of nuclear energy was banned, and all radioactive waste and materials were disposed of at an energy disposal facility in the Gibsoft Islands, a remote set of islands off the coast of the Indian Ocean. Now, international eyes were on the elimination of the intercontinental missiles that posed the biggest threat to world peace. In order to eliminate these weapons of mass destruction, they were launched outside the Earth's atmosphere and intercepted by other missiles, exploding them on contact. People around the world watched these explosions light up the sky as if they were some kind of dazzling light show. These explosions, later known as the missile shows, became the symbol of world peace. The world was filled with hope. But a new threat was on the rise. At the signing ceremony of the UN's World Security Treaty in the year 2003, a new breed of terrorists, who called themselves Smiling Faces, attacked the ceremony. The devastating attack caught the International Society by surprise and temporarily crippled key operations in the United Nations. That assault was aimed at nothing other than using terrorism to create terror. Fear spread throughout the nations like wildfire. There was nothing the police or the military could do to counter the Smiling Faces. The only ones who had any chance of stopping these Smiling Faces were the omniscient and almost godlike professional assassins. The key players behind the scenes of the four powers utilized their connections and called upon the group known as Killer 7. Their only hope rested with them.
Ooh, it's an intense cutscene there, eh? Getting a little bit of explanation as to what's going on.
Have you decided on your vote? If you haven't, please let the Republic Party make the most of your precious vote. Thank you and have a nice day.
Precious vote? Yeah, right.
What exactly was he eating there? Was that a bowl of cereal? It looked all funky junked. This is where Garcian lives. It's a nice little place if you look around. I try not to linger in here too long because this place scares me, and I can't necessarily say why. So let's go ahead and go into Harmon's room and ignore the horrible sounds in the background.
What? You want to eat? Make it fast, okay? I have to go to class at 9.
Wearing that outfit? I doubt you're going to class, honestly, Samantha. Okay, so we need to talk to our master here, Harmon. We can't talk to him in this world, so let's go ahead and just tune on the TV here and see if I can't maybe communicate with him a little bit better.
Ah, Garcian. How long has it been?
Check out the vitality on this guy. Holy shit. Okay, this is the only time we can actually switch over to Harmon like so. So let's go ahead and do so. Change. And see what happens.
The master is awake.
Garcian, relax.
As you wish, master. There's an important message for you.
Ah, yes, I've felt it. An old friend is trying to bring down a country.
I will contact you.
If there are visitors for me, call.
As you wish.
Samantha, the lights.
As you wish, Master. It's time. Can I go now?
Yeah. Thanks.
See you tomorrow, then. Thanks. Mwah.
So there goes Samantha. She watches over Harmon for us in our trailer house here. Now we need to get the fuck out. It's not really explained too well, and it may confuse you early on, but... Oh god, that noise. let's get out of here. Stop screaming, please. The answering machine, whenever we get a message, that's actually Christopher Mills. Sorry, I'm freaking out. Christopher Mills leaving us a message saying that we need to meet up because he has a mission for us, allegedly. So, we're gonna travel around here. Oh, this music's great too. Check out where we are, viewers. There's the trailer house. We're actually in Seattle, Washington. It's a really nice place. Have you guys ever been to Washington? Love it up there, seriously. Meanwhile, at the Department of Defense, some other shit is going on. Let's take a gander.
Wait, look at this.
What is this? A bug in the system?
No, sir. It's reading right. There's 200.
What the hell?
A country could disappear off the map. Do you have the impact point yet?
Yes, sir. It's Japan.
What? Are the fireworks ready?
No, forget it. Japan is our ally. No, we're not authorized to make that kind of decision. Forget authorization. We have to do something now or else. We can't just let it happen.
Get the president on the line.
This is an emergency call for the president. Mr. President, this is Spencer speaking, sir. 200 pulsars have been fired towards Japan. We're unable to compute their trajectory since we're avoiding the computation time lag. Interception can only commence 2 hours before initial impact. Shall we launch the fireworks? Mr. President, your assessment, sir.
Oh god, don't leave me hanging there. So apparently, 200 missiles, I'm guessing, are flying over towards Japan. That's not necessarily a good thing. At least I don't think it is. I guess we'll find out, eh, viewers? Alrighty, so that's enough of the Department of Defense. Let's, yeah, get back over to Washington and see what the hell Garcian is up to. Did he meet up with Mills yet? Over at the overpass. Nice. Hello?
The missiles have been launched.
Where are they headed?
Japan.
Washington?
Restaurant Fukushima. It's a popular joint.
And the target?
The owner of the place, Toru Fukushima. See, he's the middleman between the Japanese UN representatives and our government.
A government job?
It's a job from all the parties. Japan has turned against us.
So that's why they're gonna hit Japan?
Well, it's a possibility. It depends on how they move.
It'll be a blow, all right. What will happen to Japan?
It's up to the president. They have 18 hours.
All hell's gonna break loose over in Washington. And I sure as hell don't want to be there.
If, for some reason, you need help, go see a guy named Kasai. He's well-informed, especially about the Japanese movement. You got all the details in there, okay? This time, the string puller is Fukushima. Now, the integrity and the true worth of Japan is at stake here.
Interesting. That all sounds very complicated. All I know is we need to go handle this Fukushima character, apparently. So, I think that about does it for today. No, not the video, but the cutscenes. So let's go ahead and see where we are going now. I'm not controlling this, in case you're curious. This is just automatically happening here. Where are we headed? Holy shit, all the way to DC, eh? Yeah, here we go. Level start. This is gonna be interesting. Don't get scared, Alan. I know what's gonna happen. Yeah, it's always so loud. A decisive battle at the Japanese restaurant. I couldn't read it fast enough. Get rid of the governor. Toru Fukushima. Hello, governor. Let's go ahead. Assignment number 34. Oh, we're gonna get to show off some pretty cool stuff here today, aren't we? Garcian, you bother me. Hopefully we won't have to play as you too long. We're just gonna run up towards the restaurant and get this shit started. I know that we've already recorded quite a while. I'm gonna try and play for a little bit longer here, because I know you guys want to see some awesome bloody action going on here. Very, very bad. He's not saying things are tight anymore. Interesting. Sure, it looks like a sushi joint. Oh, jeez. Yeah, I don't like where this is going. Oh, well, you're just talking about the taste? What are you talking about? Well, that's interesting. Maybe I'll have to grab a bite while I'm here. Alright, that's enough of that. Through the gate we go. Maybe grab ourselves something to eat. We can have a nice gentleman's conversation with the Fukushima guy here. I'm sure everything will be just fine. Why am I shifting into a persona here? Why am I shifting into the most destructive persona? Okay. Fuck it. Yeah, burn you bitches. Masked A. Smith. Resident bad motherfucker. Alright. Check out what else he can do. If you have something blocking your path, headbutt the shit out of it, like so. Incredible. Alright.
Irashimase. Welcome. How many in your party, sir?
I want to talk to the owner.
May I ask what it's concerning?
Yeah. I'm here to kill Mr. Fukushima.
Certainly. We'll be delighted to serve you.
Oh, shit. Boom! Why would you confront a man wielding two grenade launchers, one in each fucking hand? Are you insane? Well, clearly they are. Clearly everyone is insane in this game. Let's switch over to a persona that can actually properly do something. Let me go into this hallway here first. We need to explore this area before we proceed onwards. Oh, the music here is great too. Yeah, okay, we got smiles. Let's bust out the KD girl. Alrighty. She has her counterattack now, so worst comes to worst, if I have a, you know, if they get too close, I can show off some pretty neat abilities here. Hopefully, it won't come down to that. Hurts, doesn't it? And one, two on the right leg there. Bam! Oh, that went really well. Okay. This shouldn't be hard, just for precaution's sake here. Let's reload in case I need to dump all of the bullets into this fucking thing. God damn you, I hate... She was going really slow. I think I somehow slowed her down with that shot. Okay, the smiles are respawning. That's never a good thing. Let's get you the fuck out of my face, please. Please. Heaven smile, please, check this shit out. Wait for the screen to flash, fuck it! And she fucking kicks him in the face and kills him instantly. That's a counterattack. It's extremely awesome, but letting a smile get that close to you, not a thing. Oh, is that a micro? Not a thing you really want to do on a day-to-day basis, just trust me on that one. Let's reload before I turn this corner here. Because yeah, her reload times are fucking terrible. I think they're spawning behind me, so let's go ahead and get some dialogue out of the way here and not forget that there's a guy coming from behind here. Alright, what does Mr. Pigeon Man have to say? Okay. He still hasn't gotten paid. Did the price lower? Oh yeah, it did. He's absorbing a $25 loss. Wow, that's a good deal, man. Alright. Just, he's freaking out about the money, I get it. The Smith Syndicate has many, many talents. We're gonna learn a little bit more about the personas here. What are you even talking about? People cram their, oh, I guess, and then they blow the glove up and it explodes and causes hearing loss. Yeah, I've seen that before. Alright. Dan Smith is a crazy motherfucker. He launches balls of light and shit, quote unquote. That is amazing. Oh, Daniel. Is there anything else you want to tell me? Yeah, she shoots blood out of her arms. It's very freaky. Taking out some kind of barrier. All shit that I've really explained before. She sucks blood, too. Ugh. Maste Smith. No one knows much about that guy. He does wrestling moves. Yeah, Maste Smith is a fucking wrestler. And his counterattack, he, like, suplexes guys and shit. It's crazy. Alrighty. Mysteriously disappeared. Okay, yeah, I'm a big fan, so I knew that. And there's more than meets the eye. Johnny Gagnon, thank you so much, sir. Get you out of here, Mr. Courier Man. And we got a little bit of dialogue with Travis here, too. Sniffing the flowers, taking in the sights. Number one. A number one. The bomb. I used to watch a lot of Space Ghost Coast to Coast. That quote is from... Okay. Japan's controlled by the UN. I'm trying to follow this here. Alright, the UN party goes down. Okay. I'm following you, I think. The Liberal Party would take the reins. I'm reading out loud because I have a hard time following this stuff, so I apologize. Some nasty shit cooking in this restaurant. Well, why would they cook Mama's fried chicken in a Japanese restaurant, honestly? Oh, and a little hint for us. The thief from South America could climb this shit. When you hear this noise, something is amiss. Oh, smile behind me. Holy dick. Where is he? Oh, he's getting close. I probably should just jump up there. Let's just say fuck it and just take him down the old-fashioned way. Bam. I'm pretty sure I just heard a laugh. like, a laugh that a smile is, like, jumping at me right now. So I'm just gonna frantically mash the Y button. I'm not sure if I heard it properly. You gotta have a little bit... I think you have to have a vial to use this. But anyway, Coyote can jump to extreme heights, as I mentioned before. Whew. Like so. The eagle has landed on the roof. Oh! Oh, God! Oh, that made me... Whew. That made me jump, viewers. Holy hell. That thing exploded below me, but it still damaged me? That's a little bit of a... little bullshit, honestly. Not gonna lie about it. Oh, this Mamma Jamma is right in front of me. Do you have your counterattack, Coyote? You don't, do you? Bad time to test that shit out, eh? Okay, let's move on here. To the roof we go. Coyote letting me down here. Who else did I get it for? I got it for Daniel and Khan, I think? Yeah, I got it for Khan, too. Well, we're going to be showing off Khan. I think tomorrow is when I want to do that. Yeah, that seems about right. Anyways, over the rooftop we go. Look at this pretty area here. Actually, it's just kind of a lot of darkness and shit. Not that pretty. A lot of gray and nastiness. While I'm thinking about it, let me go ahead and get fully healed. And we will press onwards here. Hopefully getting to the other side. With minimal run-ins with Heaven Smiles, please. Because apparently I'm garbage today. I don't know if you guys can hear it, but my favorite music's playing. And there's my little sweetheart here. Sweetheart Susie, apparently. Hello. Yeah. Kind of nasty out. Why not? I don't really understand either. With all her reasons. Listen to you, Susie. Yeah, it's very important. Oh, what? Why did you jump? Ouch, yeah. Totally foobarred. Wonderful. Hey! So it kind of worked out in the end, eh? Yeah, not bad. Whoopee! With the little emoticon. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I thought that looked familiar. Let me go ahead and just casually grab that out of your mouth. The water ring. Gonna be a crucial item, obviously. Got anything else to say? I don't know. It's kind of sad, actually. Oh, wow. I'm sorry, Susie. What? Wait, what? She... Susie? Okay. She... Yeah. We're not gonna talk about Susie anymore. Let me just, slide that there. You're kind of freaky. Okay, moving on. Let me... Oh, she's still looking at me. Let's, get back down that hole there. I just have to retrace my steps here. And down we are. Okay, cool. I did take down one smile on the way, so let me reload. And we're gonna have two smiles to contend with here. Fucking hell, man. Playing a lot as Coyote, apparently. I guess I play him a little bit more than I thought I did. Come on, get it. Hit the sweet spot. Yeah! Now let's quickly run through before they respawn. He has a nice default run speed, too, so he's pretty nice in that regard. Not near as good as Khan, though. Again, you'll see him tomorrow. Man, you guys are gonna love Khan, seriously. He's like a teenage kid who's actually blind, and he has fully automatic pistols, and he's super fast, and I'm getting really excited just talking about him. Obviously. Eh? Is there... I thought I heard someone. Oh god, this one's running at me. That's freaky. Okay. Shoot the head! Shoot it! Moving on here, let's just try and stay out of the... okay, I heard a smile here. Let's try and stay out of the rain and switch over to my favorite man. Oh, Daniel. I could show off the counterattack here, and I really want to, but we're going to be playing as Dan... Hey, he's right here! We're going to be playing as Dan a lot, so we're going to have ample opportunities to see the counterattack. And I try not to use it because, well, when you counterattack... You actually don't get any blood from the kill. It's kind of a last-ditch thing that you want to do. You, well, come here, you bastard. Bam! Seriously, bad motherfucker. He knows that the guys are suicide bombers, and yet he brings them in closer, pulls them in, puts his fucking revolver to their chin, and blows their brains out. Who does that? The blood red flower is going to go up. Are you talking about the missiles? Yeah, it sounds like you are. I see. That's something we need to think about, viewers, actually. Whose side are we on here? If we kill the owner... I don't want Japan to go down. But I can't betray my country, either. Wait, new enemy type. What? Suddenly I'm very distracted. What are you talking about, new enemy type? Yeah, you're about to see it here. Let's head into the lobby. And see what's going on. I can't remember which one we're going to face here. Which one is this? Oh, fuck these guys, man. I hate bomb heads. They're actually really easy to kill, but if you fuck it up, it can be very painful. Bam. You just have to shoot them in the head. That's all you have to do. If their little bomb shell head thing closes around and you shoot it, well, I think they instantly teleport to you. What? Oh, I heard one behind me. Something like that, and they explode right in your face. It's very scary, and this is not... Oh, shit. Okay! Okay, let's, calm down. Get the crits. And... That actually worked out. That's very scary. You really never want three heaven smiles that close to you. Fuck that rhythm and blues. Anyways, here we are in Harmon's room. Is this a red or a green? I can't really tell. Let's head on in, I guess. It would have been quicker just to fucking go in and look around like an idiot. If we save in here, which we are gonna do, gotta remember tomorrow that all those heaven smiles respawn, so we have to, like, fucking pull our gun out really quickly. Let me get all of my vials up and see if I can't level up. Alrighty, we didn't get too many there. Is it even worth leveling anyone up? You wanna die, huh? Yeah, they changed their dialogue in between levels, too. He's all at level 2. She's new. I'm gonna need her to be at level 2 all the way across for me to be comfortable with the boss up ahead. So let's just go ahead and get that out of the way. Next, we'll probably focus on He's at level 2 too. Maybe we'll level up Coyote a little bit. Yeah, we may as well get him up. Apparently, I use him now, so that's a thing. Okay. And then I'm just going to save up here at the ever-lovely Samantha, and we're going to call it a day. As always, thank you so much for watching, viewers, and I will see you next time.